Good afternoon, YouTube. Welcome to my channel. Right, it's the 29th of April. It's a Wednesday, and I'm here up north in Lancashire at Mum's because she had a fall a couple of weeks ago, and my brother and I are taking turns to look after it, to look after Mum because she's broken her shoulder in four places and she's can't do much there. So yeah, I'm up here in Wharton, in Lancashire, in the Fylde. So yeah, this is where I'm from, really. Well, I'm not from Wharton, I'm from Kirkham. But the area I am from, and this is my mum's. I'm on Mr. Fat Harry White, I brought him up with me. Mum's house, and little garden. There we go. So it's all good, so I'm just going to go out for a little spin. It's 15 miles. I'm going out to Lytham. Up to St Anne's, Fairhaven Lake, following the Lancashire Coastal Path, and I'm coming doubling back and then heading off down the Ribble Estuary towards Freckleton and then back in. So right, in a bit, peeps.
Okay, let's head out of Ash Drive. Okay, straight in front of us, that's BAC Wharton. That's where they make the typhoons and all that good stuff. And we're going to be turning right onto the Lytham Road. So yeah, I'm from Lancashire. Originally born in Lytham, and we're heading up there now. And the area where this is, it's called the Fylde, and it comes from an old Viking word, I think, called the field, gefeld. So there you go, a bit of history, Mr. Collingwood. God, it's a bit breezy. I've had rain since 12, stopped about 3 o'clock, and now it's brined up. There's a bit of a wind going on. Cycle Path Extreme! Okay, this place here, this is the land registry for the United Kingdom of England, Cestershire. There you go, a bit of interest for you. So the reason this place is called the Fylde, like I say before, I'm sure it's an old Viking word, the gefeld, which means field. And it was given that name because the Fylde is very flat, the land is very fertile, and it's good for growing stuff. So that's why it's called the field, because it's good for agriculture. So there you go. All right, so when we come back, we'll be heading back down here. We'll be heading off there, following the coastal path along in the Ribble Estuary into Preston. And here we are, Lytham. Welcome to Lytham, Lancashire coastal gem, birthplace of Andy Musser, 4th of April, 1964. Happy days, boys. That was a good day for the earth. All right, here we go, public footpath. And here we go. This is the part of the Lancashire coastal path. We'll be coming back down here on the way back and then heading off up the other way. But now we're heading off to Lytham seafront. In a bit. Look at all the boats and stuff. Boaty McBoat Face. Magpie, one for sorrow. Hope it doesn't rain. Bluebells, very nice. Yeah, a little bit of a tiny river estuary. Not sure what that one's called. But it ain't the Ribble. Okay, we're joining the road again. I'll take us back into Lytham. Okay, this is Lytham now. Heading on in. As you can see, this is Lytham Hospital. Birthplace of me. This is the new hospital now. They've knocked the old one down. But yeah, this is where I was born. 4th of April, 1964. So yeah, and Zoe Ball was also born in this hospital a few years after me. So there you go. Interesting fact number two. You're welcome. Heading off up to the coast now. We're going to turn left and then get up on the coastal path. Well, ride along the promenade. Totally the wrong bike for this, but this is all I've got. There you go. Right, across the estuary there, that's the Ribble Estuary, out to sea. You've got Southport, and then you can just see, well, I can see in the distance, Snowdonia. Oh man, I want to go there big time. So anyway, this is Lytham Seafront. There's Wimmill, we're heading right down to St Anne's. Yeah, all good. So yeah, looking over at the mountains of Snowdonia over there. Oh, it looks lovely. Lytham Windmill. People there. An old anchor. What an anchor. And we've got the lifeboat station up ahead. Remember years ago when I was a kid, used to come here by the lifeboat station, and they had all the little shrimp carts. I just remember seeing them loaded up with shrimps, and they were for sale in Lytham, and probably went all around the country really. Lytham shrimps. Yeah, that was back in the day, back in the 70s. Right. So that's Lytham there. This is like the trendy end of town. Some really nice restaurants there. And it's actually quite posh, Lytham, now. There's a cracking ale house called The Taps. My brother introduced it to me and it's lush. So yeah, The Taps in Lytham. Cracking pizza shop, as well, pizza restaurant. Yeah, it's very, very upmarket, swanky town now. It's really cool. All right, the cycle path's closed. That little bit on the left now, they're doing some work on it, and it goes to Granny's Bay. So, heading into St Anne's now. We're still in Lytham, but we'll soon be getting to St Anne's. Right, we're going to be turning left here to Fairhaven Lake. We're going to go to the top of the lake, and then we're going to double back ourselves and then head out to the Ribble Estuary. Let's get up on it. Naughty, naughty. Okay. Fairhaven Church of the Whiteness. Not sure what that's all about, but it's whatever floats your boat. Right, there we go, back at the sea. So yeah, they're doing a lot of work to the front here. Make it look really nice. My brother said it'd be interesting. So yeah, you can see what they're doing now, doing all the frontage. So just over there, that's Fairhaven Lake. Used to come there as a kid. So we're gonna ride up to the top of the lake and then just come all the way back. But yeah, getting closer to Snowdonia. I can see even closer now. Right, it looks as if we can't get up the side of Fairhaven Lake. So we'll just ride up here a bit, give you a little shot of Fairhaven Lake. And then we're heading all the way back. There you go, Fairhaven Lake. Pretty cool. And this is the only place, okay, I was in the army for 12 years, and this is the only place where I've seen a stalwart actually swim when I was a kid. We had a demonstration, or some display in the 70s, and it went in at some rate or not, so it was bloody awesome to watch. But yeah, so this is Fairhaven Lake, straight on. You get deep into St Anne's, and then Blackpool, and Fleetwood. But now, we is heading back that way. Right, coming back into Lytham now. Signed for Lytham Hall, that's where Roger does his park runs. Here we go, coastal gem, Lytham, birthplace of moi. And it's windy! A great look at the sea. So you can look over there, you've got the Pennines, sun shining on them. How very, very cool. Extreme beach pebble action! Right, let's see if we can just ride along here for a little bit. Oh, spinning in the shale. spin, spin, spin. Bloody hell, that's hard work. Now we're on sand now. We've got the windmill up ahead, lifeboat station, Pennines over there, Winter Hill, where the TV mast is. So here we're at the lifeboat station again. We'll go round and then back onto the path and then head out of Lytham. So you go straight ahead, you've got the Pennines, you've got Winter Hill with the TV mast just over there. Sun is shining on the Pennines and it looks lovely. Yeah, real nice. Right, let's get back up and head on out of Lytham. Let's go and get a nice picky of the windmill. Okay, coming out of Lytham now, we're going to head off down there, pick up the coastal path along the River Estuary. Right, here we go again. Lytham Hospital, where I was born. 1964. What a day that was. Right, we're gonna cross over now. Once this car's gone, we're gonna pick up the coastal path on the other side. So that's where we went just before. Up there, we're going just the other side. And then head out onto the salt flats and the estuary. And here it is. Can we, it's a stile. Right, let's just push it to the top of the bank. Roger did this the other day when I turned up Monday, and he ran from Mum's house in Wharton that way. Ran all down and then he ran all along where we're going to go now. He said it was amazing. So we went across the other side along there and now we're here out on the old marshland, so let's get on. Oh, it's bloody cow muck. Right, so as we approach this, Lytham is that way, Preston is that way, we're going that way. There's Winter Hill again right in front of you, the Pennines. Looks like we've got some beasts. It's just unfortunate they're not horses, so I can go horses, horse, horse, horse. Right, we'll go steady for the Milky Girls. Okay, ladies, stay calm, it's all right. It's just some old guy on a mountain bike. Are you a horse? No. Say bye-bye, horse.
Goodbye.
And on we go. This wind, well, riding in this wind is going to be another good test of the Remuvu wind jacket and the GoPro. Toby, if you ain't got one, get one, they're brilliant! This must be the house Roger was on about. He said there's a real modern swanky house. And that's it. So, yeah, just going to head on down, quick right, then right again, then pick up the trail. Yeah, very nice. V modern. Yeah, so we just come down that little bit there, cross over the bridge, and now we're going back up here, past the swanky house. God, I just pressed my dropper paddle the wrong way on my thumb, and it's bloody killing. Right, swanky house. I'm not really into the garden ornaments, the JCB stuff. Get rid of them. Look, might look quite nice after. Looks like work in progress. Oh shit, another stile. Christ, it's a good job I didn't have the e-bike for that one. I had to lift it right over that crap. Shit, my shoulders are hurting already from the other day with Mark lifting that e-bike. I think I've ripped my tendons a bit more in my shoulder, but we'll keep quiet about that. Right, we're heading off down there. Oh, the driftwood there. You won't have to, if you lived here, you wouldn't be short of firewood, would you? That's assuming you had a log burner. Right, I think I'm going to have to lift over this one as well. It's one of them awkward ones, but hey ho, let's give it a go. Right, we're over the stile. And I'm not sure if you can make them out on the GoPro, but you will do in a bit. You got the yellow lights. They are the approach lights to Warton Aerodrome. And this route will take us around the back of Warton Aerodrome. And hopefully, we'll get to see the place where I used to mess around when I was a kid. We used to come and look at where the Flying Fortresses used to park in the Second World War, because Warton Aerodrome was an American air base and they had Flying Fortresses there. And there's a very sad story, which I will tell you later on down there. Okay, in a bit. Right, I've just got the aerodrome to my left now. Just had a quick glance of it, so hopefully you should get to see it in a bit. Okay. Oh. Off we go. Coastal Path Extreme. Bloody hell. Come on, ladies. Move south. Oh. This is jolly nice. Ah, another stile. So let's just take in the view. That's where we are, Southport, Snowdonia, heading on down there. Getting a bit biffed off with these stiles now, or these gates. Oh well. Footbridge. I think Roger told me about that. And another gate. Ouch, 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 bloody hell. And yet another gate. Thank you, Gate Master. Right, this must be the bit you're on about, Roger. Knackered North Shore. Yeah, that's a bit of crap. I ain't riding that. Anyway, let's get through this other gate. Right, this is for you, Rog. Styling over the knackered North Shore. Look at that. Bunny hop. It's giving way. Anyway. The awesomeness was for you, Rog. Okay, so we're riding around the edge, the perimeter fence now of Warton Aerodrome, which was an American air base in the Second World War. Flying Fortresses. He used to come down here and mess around with a friend at the time, Martin Bamber. Yeah, it was really good fun. Oh, this was a bloody mistake, wasn't it? On track. Something squeaking on my bike. And it ain't me. So where we are, we're heading off down there. You see the Pennines over there. Now the Ribble has turned in now. The Ribble's, the estuary goes out and then the coastline goes around and up there towards Blackpool. So yeah, this is now coming inland. And I think one of the pads which the Flying Fortresses used to stand on is up here. There's a circular feature marked on the map, so I'm going to have a look at it. Looks like it's creaking on this bloody thing. Right, the circular feature should be just up here. But I don't know, we'll have to see. Riding on the skinny mud wood. These are the tyres, which Rog, no, I'll give that a miss. Probably end up going in the crap. Okay, Rog, for you again. Skips. Bit of trial action. And skips. 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 And down it goes. It's a clean from the lad from Lancashire. Apart from these little bits. Here we go now. Buff. 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 Oh yes, over the foam. Excellent. Last one. Buff. Excellent. Gotta watch the gaps. Ooh. Quite off putting really. There we go. Over the little bridgey thing. Yeah, I thought we had some planes up in the sky, but it was just the wind going through the mesh fence here. Oh well.
Okay, so yeah, we're at the back of Warton Aerodrome. So years ago, back in the old 70s, kid used to come down and mess around here with Martin Bamber, a friend of mine, and we were told at school at the time there were some big concrete circular pads where the flying fortresses used to stand when they weren't being flown, and we used to come and look for them, and we found them, but as you can see it's all overgrown now. But yeah, it's quite interesting, you know, flying fortress base back in the war. And so another good story, there's a River Ribble there going in, and again back in the day in the 70s, my dad was into fishing, liked his sea fishing and fly fishing, and he got word there was there's a massive shoal of grey mullet coming down the estuary. So he hopped in his car, me, Roger and Dad, and we were somewhere down here, and I remember it vividly to this day. We went on this side, and it was all that grass was mud, and you could see these bloody mullet jumping, heading downstream, and Dad managed to mishook one and caught it. And he did sink in the sand in the mud quite badly, and we managed to get him out, but he mishooked this mullet fish, grey mullet, took it home and cooked it, and it was the nicest piece of sea fish I've ever had the pleasure of eating in my life. So yeah, if you get grey mullet on the menu, get it, because it's lush. Okay, let's crack on.
There we go. Nice shot of the Ribble Estuary. Heading down into Preston. Nice little front bridge here. Extreme front bridge crossing. Got a little walk up here, see what we can see. River Ribble. I say, back in the day, all this grass would have been mud. Great gloopy mud, and Dad went up to his bloody knee in it and deep, I think. Yeah. Real nice. That's looking down to Preston there, around the corner. Out to the North Sea. Coming inland. Remember when there was a primary school at Strike Lane, which is behind us somewhere over there. Remember from the playing field, you could see the ships going down to the docks in Preston. Yeah, that's quite exciting as a kid in primary school. Not quite sure where the footpath goes, so we'll just try and make it up as we go along. God, bumpy, 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 bloody hell, that's slippy enough. I think it goes over there. Let's go and have a look. Okay, it just goes up there. Just had to leave some boisterous brown cows behind. They wanted to follow me. Okay, here's a finger post now, heading on up into Freckleton. And Roger said this is a challenge, and I can see why. So I don't think so, Rog. That's a get off and push. All right then, Rog. I am declining your challenge. No way. Ugh. Not a hope. Now, where's the walk mode on this? Oh, it's through there. Is it? Oh, shit. That's a bit of a twatty entrance. I'm going to struggle with that one, but all part of the fun. Let's go, peeps. Whee! But yeah, that's awkward. Down we go and up we go. And we'll push. I even struggle on the e-bike on this, it's quite loose. And another freaking gate. Alright. Let's just go to the trig point. Tap it and wrap it. And there you go. Over there you got Hesketh Bank. Over there. On the other side of the Ribble. Right, I'm just gonna cut the ride a bit short now. I'm just conscious of the time. And it's taking longer than expected. I need to get home and make sure Mum's okay. So yeah, it's just a little bit of Freckleton Brook. So now we're just heading back into Freckleton on this little track here. But yeah, I just need to get back, make sure Mum, she is okay. I've just phoned her, but where have you been? I could be you dying. So I'll get on back. Okay, years ago, 70s again. We had a walk from primary school. And we came along here, in fact here, just behind me. And it was because the Concorde had just been built and it was doing the fly past. And it was flying around Great Britain. And we came and stood here and it came across. And I just remember as a little kid, a little primary school kid, the deafening noise because it came in really low. Incredible. And also on the opposite side of the runway, there's a runway there. And at the opposite side, we used to come down on the bikes for kids. And we used to stand at a gate and watch the planes taking off and land. And it was the only time I've ever seen it. It was the English Electric Lightning. It just taxied up the runway here, turned around, stopped where we were, whacked on his bloody engines, shot off and did that vertical takeoff. That was something to see. I'm just quite pleased to say I've actually seen that. Okay, this is Freckleton now. Freckleton. Tons of freckles. Naughty, naughty. Yeah. Oh, just got a whiff of chip shop curry there. There we go, Freckleton Bowling Club and Memorial Park. They put the memorial on the site of the school. So let's go and have a quick look at it. Okay, here we are. Okay, so there's a memorial stone there. It says, in memory of the children who died the 23rd of August 1944, in fields remote from these, their lost bright laughter will ring forever, innocent and sweet, and unknown flowers where they run thereafter will bloom like fadeless stars beneath their feet. That's by Charles E. Butler. Really sad. So this is it here. This is the site of what was the school where the Flying Fortress crashed. So this is the memorial. And here we go. It says, this playground presented to the children of Freckleton by their American neighbours of Base Air Depot No. 2, United States Air Force, in recognition and remembrance of their common loss in the disaster of August the 23rd, 1944. That's really sad. And this is the site of the school here. Right, let's get back. Well, Grandma, I think Grandma's going to kill me anyway. So let's go. So there we go, that was the memorial to what happened on the 23rd of August 1944. All those children died when the plane crashed. Right, let's make some good headway because Mum's going to go mad. crack on. Do another red light. Right, so here we are. BAC to our left, we're going to turn right and get to Mother's. Ooh. Not far now, Mother, I'm coming. Right, here we go, Ash Drive. That's taken longer than I expected, actually. There's the car. Give them a knock on the door, tell Mother I'm home, do the piece to camera to end it, then go and get some scoff. Oh, dear me.
Right, I've just checked on Mother. She's cool, she's on the phone to Auntie Nora. He's been out on his mountain bike. Anyway, bless her. No, it's all good. Well, there you go. That was the Wharton to Lytham to Fairhaven, Ribble Estuary back to Freckleton and Wharton route. A totally wrong bike for it. But that's all I've got, so that was really nice, actually. 2 hours, 20 minutes in total. There's me saying to my mum, I'll be an hour 15, hour 15, no problem. But yeah, it's really nice, actually. Had to cut it short because of the time to get back to mum. But yeah, well, I hope you liked it. Hit the like button and subscribe. Have they say like and subscribe? Okay, until the next random content. In a bit, peeps, and from Mark and Jane Harley, stay cool.